don't know about. And I'm talking about the clause in not a contract, but a buyout specifically, yeah, separate from a contract that Cloud9 and G2 signed. When Cloud9 bought out Perkz at the end of last offseason and said, hey, you're gonna come over here, a clause was in there that said Perkz cannot sign with Fnatic at any point over the next 3 years. That includes 2021, 22, yeah, then 23. I don't even have a question. Like, what happened? How does that come, yeah, about? How does Perkz not, you know about it? Why is it a part of the buyout specifically, but not the contract? How do those machinations work? What do you got to know in 3 minutes?
So I want to state this for the record, and I'll look deadpan to camera for this. Perkz did not sign that. Shut the hell up if you are saying that. Perkz did not sign that. It's not in his contract. It's in a contract between G2 and Cloud9. It was signed without his consent. He had no say in the matter. If he wanted to go to Fnatic, he could not, period. And, you know, Riot's position on this is basically that it didn't affect his prospects. More or less what I understand of the situation is that Fnatic went to C9 and they said, okay, we would like Perkz. And C9 said, okay, here's the money. Here's what we want for his buyout, and here's what he wants his starting salary. Negotiated out with him later. And Fnatic said, no, we're not comfortable with that. And then Vitality came in the picture, had the same conversation, and said, okay, yes, we would like this. But, like, yes, we're good with those numbers. We'll get there. And they said, but we would like exclusive rights to negotiate with Luka, with Perkz, right? And they got it. And then Fnatic came back, and we're like, okay, we'll try it again. Like, we're ready. And Cloud9 said, oh, well, sorry, we already sailed. Gave, yep, ship sailed. Team Vitality's, you know, in the process of getting this done. And here we are. He's going to Team Vitality. But I want to make it really clear. I know that League of Legends fans maybe don't have the best of understanding of how these things work. Perkz did not sign that. That is not in his contract. He did not consent to that. It was between the two teams, and some people may argue, oh, well, you know, if he would have really wanted to go to Fnatic, it would have been waived or whatever else, but it wasn't. And I know Riot said that they're not going to allow it anymore, and they're not going to enforce that one. Too late. He's already going to be going to Team Vitality by the time that Riot had made that decision. So we're already here, and I think that needs to be really well understood, that this was done behind his back, more or less, to be honest. And I, you know, he didn't have the power here. And this is like why people like me are very, very firm about why, you know, unionization of the LCSPA and other things are really important, because I think a player should have a conversation. I mean, hell, that clause is potentially illegal under antitrust matters, depending on who you get in front of and argue in front of in court, if it went that far, which I don't think it will. But that could be potentially illegal in antitrust matters too, and could violate a bunch of different things that exist in traditional sports. But we're in this sort of unprecedented, untapped market of esports. So, you know, to me, like, we're looking at the situation where, like, something was done. I personally think it's, you know, kind of crappy, and I'm very disappointed, to be frank. But yeah, I just wanted to make that really clear, because I think a lot of people don't understand that.